In this lesson, we will resolve complex rational expressions with repeated linear factors in the denominator to partial fractions. Let's get started with the given rational expression. Here, the given rational expression is given rational expression is 2x squared minus 3x plus 4 divided by x minus 1 power 3. This time, x minus 1 is a linear factor, but it's repeating 3 times. Therefore, we are going to introduce 3 constants, one for each repetition. So this is equal to a over x minus 1 plus b for second repetition. This would be x minus 1 square plus c divided by x minus 1 cube. Now take the LCM on right hand side and then cancel it out with the one on the left. This will give us 2x squared minus 3x plus 4 equal to a into x minus 1 square plus b into x minus 1 plus c. Now, if we substitute x minus 1 equal to 0, we can get the value of c like before. So let's put x minus 1 equal to 0 means x equal to 1 in this equation, which is called equation number 1. To get the value of c, because x minus 1 is present in a and in b, both of them will become 0, giving us c on the right hand side. So this will be 2 times 1 square minus 3 times 1 plus 4 equal to a into 0, because x minus 1 is 0, plus b into 0, because x minus 1 again is there and that is equal to 0, plus c. So this gives us 2 minus 3 plus 4 equal to c. Here, this means c is equal to 3. That is value for c. Unlike before, we don't have any other linear factor which we can put to equal to 0 and get values for a, b, c. So we are going to use a new technique, which is comparing the coefficients of the highest power of x, which is appearing in equation 1. So that's why for finding unknown a and b, for a and b, we compare coefficients of highest powers of x. So first we will compare coefficients of x square, because that is the highest power that occurs in equation 1. On left hand side, the coefficient of x square is 2. So 2 will be compared with, so 2 will be equal to a on the right side. Because when you expand this term will expand into x squared minus 2x plus 1. A, when multiplied inside, will give us coefficient of x squared as a. So this will be a. And similarly, if you take a look, there is no x square in the second term, and there is no x square in the third term. Therefore, a is equal to 2. So this is how we can find out the value for a. And now, because b is still not known, therefore we are going to lower down the degree of x for comparison. So now we will be comparing coefficients of x on both sides. Powers of x, that is x squared and x. So from comparison of x squared, so this is what we got from comparison of powers. Of x. Comparison of coefficients. Okay. Now we are going to compare coefficients of x on both sides. So for that purpose, in equation 1, if you take a look, what is coefficient of x on left side? That is minus 3. So here it's minus 3, equal to. And what will be the coefficient of x if we expand a into x minus 1 whole square? This will give us coefficient of x as minus 2a. Minus 2a plus b. So this would be minus 2a plus b. Because if you expand a into x minus 1 squared, this will be a into x squared minus 2 x plus 1, and we will have a x squared minus 2 a x plus a. So you can see that the coefficient of x is minus 2 a in the first term, and in the second term there is b. Because we already have the value for a, since a is equal to 2, therefore minus 2 is equal to minus 2 times 2 plus b. This gives us minus 2 equal to, this is minus 3 on left side. Yes, this is minus 3 here. Minus 3 here, and here it is minus 3 equal to minus 4 plus b. So from here we can find value for b as b equal to minus 3 plus 4. This gives us b equal to 1. So we have found values of a, b, and c. So let's substitute these values of a, b, and c in equation 0 here. Substituting these values of a, b, and c. Substituting values of a, b, and c in equation 0, we get 2x squared minus 3x plus 4 divided by x minus 1 whole cube equal to a. What was a? A was 2. This would be 2 over x minus 1. And what is b? B is equal to 1 as well. Plus b is 1 over x minus 1 square. And what is c? C is equal to 3 plus 3 over x minus 1 cube. So here you can see that the complex rational expression has been converted into sum of simpler fractions. Let's do another example. Example number 2. This time we have given expression. Given expression is 1 over x plus 1. 1 over x plus 1 into x minus 3 square. X minus 3 square. So you can see that x plus 1 is not repeating. So just like before, we don't need to introduce more than one constants for x plus 1. So this would be a over x plus 1, just like before. But x minus 3 is repeating twice, so we need two constants. B divided by x minus 3, and one more constant for second repetition, so this would be c divided by x minus 3 square. Let's call this as zero equation, and now take LCM on right hand side. So taking LCM on right hand side, we'll have 1 equal to a into x minus 3 square plus b into x plus 1 into x minus 3 plus c into x plus 1. We can get the values of a and c by putting x plus 1 equal to 0 and x minus 3 equal to 0, but for b we'll need to compare coefficients. To find a, put x plus 1 equal to 0. Because x plus 1 is present in all other terms, therefore x equal to minus 1 will give us 1 equal to a into minus 1 minus 3 square. So this will give us value of a equal to 1 over 16. For c, let's put x minus 3 equal to 0, x minus 3 equal to 0. This will give us x equal to 3. So if we substitute this again, we have 1 equal to a time x minus 3 is present, so that will become 0. X minus 3 is present in the second term, that will become 0, plus c time, so c into 3 plus 1. This will give us value of c equal to 1 by 4. We have values for a and c. Now we are going to compare coefficients for b. Comparing coefficients of the highest powers of x, comparing coefficients of highest powers of x, and what is the highest power of x? That would be x square. If we compare coefficient of the highest power of x, which is x square, on both sides, on left side there is no x square, so the coefficient will be equal to 0. 0 is equal to, in the first term there will be coefficient of x square will be a, and in the second term coefficient of x will be b again, because x plus 1 into x minus 3. So here you have, if we just explain, b time x plus 1 into x minus 3. If you multiply this, this will become b into x square minus 3x plus x minus 3. This is equal to b time x square minus 2x minus 3. So what is coefficient of x square? That is b. And similarly, for, so this would be a plus b. And now we can substitute the value of a. A was equal to 1 over 16. 0 is equal to 1 over 16 plus b. This gives us, because a is equal to 1 over 16. So here b will be equal to minus 1 by 16. And substituting the values of a, b, and c in equation 1. Substituting values of a, b, and c in equation 0. What we get is a is 1 by 16, so this will be 1 over x plus 1 into x minus 3 square equal to a is 1 over 16. So this will be 1 over 16 into x plus 1. B is minus 1 by 16. So this will be minus 1 over 16 into x minus 3. And c will be plus 1 by 4 into x minus 3 square. So you can see that the given rational expression has been broken down into simpler fractions.